The Sustainable Development Goal 6 speaks about ensuring access to water and sanitation for all. It talks about the need for us to have a clean environment so the people will stay healthy. However, the people of Mount Priscilla and a suburb of Lichiman in the Borno East region are lamenting the negative effects of insanitary conditions within their community. For the umpteenth time, we are here to tell this same story. City authorities, the last time we came here, you know, responded swiftly by evacuating the heap of refuse then. However, a few months later, we've gone back to the same spot where we were before. The refuse has been dumped here, abandoned by authorities, and this is the level we've got into. We've been speaking with some community people on how this is affecting them in terms of their health and sanitation.
This refuse site is affecting us in diverse ways. The stench alone is worrying, so we'll be grateful if they come to our aid.
How do you believe me? For who had a bowler, yeah. Bowler, Mimi. So what I say? Yes, I say, Gun and Penny for Omahana Munya and one, not bowling in Philip. Because we have a house here.
We wish authorities would come to our aid because we have a worship center here and there are school children all over. And when it's about to rain, the wind blows polythene bags into our homes and the road also gets flooded, making it difficult for people to get access to their homes. These residents who are currently overwhelmed by the current situation say they do not know where to channel their grievances to after being neglected by city authorities.
I say, Oka Asembia, what's a munkuba bia? Because I said, wouldn't impenny be a wine or cobana mania? Wouldn't you mean bobia mania?
We don't know where to channel our grievances to. We are happy you are here, because without you, we won't be able to reach the authorities, because we are also humans, and the situation is
worrying.
There are clusters of schools around this every site, and the closest of these schools is Aswad Islamic Academy. Pupils of the school have been sharing with us how the abandoned refuse dump is affecting their academic activities. Basma Yusuf is a class 5 pupil of the school.
It affects us every day, because when the sun scorch on it and it will be blowing us and the smell too is unpleasant, so we can't, every day we suffer like that, so we need you to come and help us.
Even though the World Health Organization has declared that the COVID-19 pandemic isn't a global health emergency anymore, pupils of this school, Aswad Islamic Academy, are being forced to still remain in their nose masks, not for COVID-19, but due to the stench that emanates from the refuse site that has been abandoned and positioned just behind the school. There are times school has to close because of the nature of the smell or odor that disrupts their studies almost on a daily basis.
The refuse dump, it affects us a lot in our education. Sometimes when we are studying in class, we are learning, busy learning. The smell, the refuse dump releases a bad smell which causes us to end the class. We move downstairs nearby the tree to get some fresh air, unless we can't continue.
Also, in terms of their health, final year pupils who are kept here as boarders are being affected heavily because the refuge site breeds mosquitoes, which, you know, eventually bring about malaria. And as I speak to you, some 3 pupils of this school are currently hospitalized because they've been diagnosed of malaria.
Some of us are in the boarding house and we can't even sleep at the night due to the mosquitoes. And mosquitoes too, when it bites you, you will contract malaria. Few weeks ago, 3 of our students have been admitted in the hospital, and even this morning one was complaining that she is sick and she is not able to come to school today. She is at the dormitory right now.
Aside this, house flies are all over during lunchtime, and this is also bringing about another health threat, possibly cholera. These pupils are currently subjected to this, and they are calling on authorities to come to their aid to save their education and then their health.
We don't feel comfortable when we are eating. And even a few months ago, we stopped eating the canteen due to the house flies. And even at this time, when we are about to eat the lunch, house flies are on the food, so we can't even eat the food.
Basma Yusuf, however, has a passionate appeal to government and city authorities.
I want to tell government that please, we beg them, they should come and push this rubbish for us. We are suffering every day when we come to school. Every day when I come to school, one problem I think is that when I come to school, this refuse them, though, I am afraid to fall sick again. That's so. I wish government to come and push the rubbish down so we get our freedom. So we'll be free from not falling sick anymore. That's all I wish from government. Thank you.
Until something urgent is being done about this precarious situation, this abandoned refuse site will continue to pose as a threat to public health to the people living here and the thousands of school-going children schooling around. Anna Sabit, Joy News, Techiman.